I'm going to show you Nest Secure. It is the security alarm system from Nest, the smart home unit of Google. I'm going to show you the parts of the system, how you install the parts, and how it all works together through the app. So if you're considering buying one of these, watch this video and you'll get a much better idea about the product. So these are the parts that come in the box. There is the Nest Guard. This is the main base unit. This includes an alarm and it also includes a motion detector. So if you put this in your hallway, you don't necessarily need any sort of detection on the front door, because as soon as someone opens the door, this is going to pick them up. You also have these things called Nest Detect. These are the sensors that you'd put on doors and windows. They work with a magnet, just like any other magnetic-based entry sensor that you have in an alarm system. One of the interesting things about these, though, is that they also include a motion sensor. So they will not only guard an entryway, a door or a window, but they'll also detect if anyone's moving around the room, whether they come in through those doors or windows or not. You can also place these in things like hallways as basic motion detectors. And they have a little light in them as well, which Nest calls path light. And that works at nighttime. When the lights are off, if you walk past this at nighttime and it detects movement, then it will switch the light on as a sort of night light to illuminate the corridor or the area in front of the door. Another couple of interesting features on those. And then you have these little RFID tags. These are used to tag the system on or tag the system off in lieu of a passcode. You can also use a passcode, but if you have one of these on your key, it's pretty easy to use. So these are the main parts of the system. One of the first things you're going to want to do is to install one of these sensors. So this is how you do it. And if you have a Nest system, you'll recognize this is the Nest app. You have feeds from Nest cameras, a doorbell and an outdoor security camera here, an indoor camera that only comes on when someone is away from the home. And then there's the Nest Guard, and there's already one door sensor on here. I'm going to add another door sensor. So we go down to add product. And then like all Nest products, there's a barcode on the back. And the easiest way to add it is to scan the barcode. All right, it's already scanned. And it tells you a little bit about the device, and then it tells you to take out the battery tab. That would be correct if this was a new device, but I've already had this in use, so I'm just going to pop a battery into it. And then it's going to look for it and it's going to try to connect. So while this is connecting up, I'm going to tell you something about the little button on the end here. This has an interesting feature that when you want to leave the house, say early in the morning, if everyone else is asleep, you can press this button and it momentarily disables the sensor for a few seconds. It allows you to open the door, go out, close the door behind you, and you haven't disabled the entire alarm system. And that means that as soon as the door is closed, everything is still enabled, and that door too re-enables itself when you close the door. So another nice little innovation that's been added to this. Okay, this is already now added to the Nest account, so we've got this working. I am going to put the back panel on here. Nest supplies a couple. There's this basic one here, which you'd just use if you're putting it up against a door or a window. And there's a sort of right angle one. If you're using this as a motion detector and you're going to put it in the corner of a room, you would use that one. But this one is just going to be used as a basic detector. Let's go back into the app here. And it's now going to try to guide me through the installation. So the first thing it's going to do is ask me where it is. So I'm going to say it's going to go on a door. And it's going to be a sliding door, and it's going to be the let's say the door to my deck. And then what's it asking me to do now? And it's a it's an entryway sensor. So it's going to get me to test the magnets here, and you will see that as I bring this together, we should get a green light on there. We do indeed, because it's working. This is where you would attach it to your door, and now it's going to ask you to pull them apart to make sure that it works, and it does. So like other security systems, there are three basic modes. First of all, off. Everything is switched off. The alarm is not monitoring anything. There's the away mode when everything is being monitored and if something happens, the alarm will go off. And then there's the home mode, which is when it's monitoring sensors around the edge of your house, so sort of entry sensors, doors and things like that. But it's not doing any motion detection inside the house because you've told it that people are at home. That's the one you'll use at nighttime so that if someone tries to break into your house, the alarm goes off. But if you walk around, it doesn't go off. You can set those on the main screen here. If we go to Nest Guard, you can see across here, I can put it into home mode, or I can put
it have 1 minute to exit
into away mode. I'm going to switch that off for the time being. And then also on here is the current status of the different sensors. This is the entryway input, the keypad here, and I said it has a motion detector. Motion detector set to off because I've got the system set off. But if I move, for example, this door, you can see that now the deck door has moved up to open. So it's as easy as that. And you can monitor it through this app. There's a bunch more settings inside the app. Let's look at some of those. We've got home and away assist. It can adjust security when you use the app. Also, it will try to remind you if you leave home and you didn't set the alarm to away, you'll get a notification on your cell phone screen saying, hey, it looks like you're out of your house. Do you want to switch your alarm on? So it tries to remind you so you don't forget something like that. There is an adjustment for the security levels. Quiet open is the feature where if you press the button on the Nest, it allows you to open a door and leave. And then the system rearms as soon as the door is closed. That can be set to on or off. If you don't want that enabled, you don't have to have it. Motion detection, and you can, if you want, reduce motion sensitivity if you're getting a lot of false alarms. So let's go back one step here. Nest does have a professional monitoring service, which is where that will be enabled. And there's also a cellular backup service. Again, you're going to have to pay for those. And some of the alarm options. So to set the alarm, do you want a passcode or not? Pretty easy and straightforward. Most people will probably say no. But maybe if you've got kids that are always pressing buttons, you don't want them to set the alarm. The countdown you get when you come home, it can be anywhere from 0 to 5 minutes. Zero sounds a little bit scary because then as soon as you open the door, the alarm is going to go off. However, of course, that will still work for you if you disable the alarm with the app before you open the door and you walk in. And then you've also got the countdown when you leave as well. You've got anywhere from 30 seconds up to 5 minutes for the system to switch on when you walk out. And then there's some settings here for some of the different sensors. So let's look at one of these input sensors. That path light function, which is switching the little white LED on inside it as you walk by in the nighttime. You can switch that on or off. If you have it off, you're going to save battery a little bit. Motion detection can be set on or off per sensor. And you also have these open tones. Which are those? You can set those on and off per sensor. And then you can adjust things like the placement of the device so the system knows exactly where it is. So let's look at what happens when you decide to arm the alarm. You can do it on the app here, or we can do it on here. We've got the off button, we've got the home and guarding, or we've got the away.
You have 30 seconds to exit.
So now I've set this. This is going to count down 30 seconds. And then also at the same time, the app is showing that it's now in the away mode. As soon as this finishes counting down, the system's going to be armed. And then any of these sensors, if they detect anything that's a door opening or closing or movement, then the system's going to be triggered. It is now armed. So let's give it a bit of movement. And now we can type a PIN code in, or we can use
sound in 10 seconds.
Or we can use one of these tags to stop it. And that's as easy as it is. If you want, you could put a PIN code in. Let me rearm this.
You have 30 seconds to exit.
Now, the whole system has been quite well quite well put together in terms that these devices do a lot of different things, like the sensors that double as motion sensors or as entryway sensors, or the base station that has a motion sensor in it as well. So it is a bit more expensive, but you only need to buy a fewer pieces. This is going to arm again, and this time I'm not going to switch it off so you can hear the alarm.
The alarm will sound in 10 seconds.
All right. This is the bit.
Please enter your passcode.
I hate the most. That is incredibly loud. That's why I had to switch it off so fast. But that's kind of what the alarm sounds like. Now, as you should have already figured out, there are a lot of voice prompts on this system.
The deck door was opened.
Including when doors are opened or motion is sensed anywhere. I'm gonna switch this off with the tag. And you'll get the same prompts as well if there's an error with the system when you go to arm it.
The deck door is open.
Don't want that. So it's a pretty easy to use system. It's quite user friendly. Nest also allows you to set different access levels for these tags. So you can actually give a tag to someone like a dog walker or a cleaner. They have the ability to come in and out of your house, but their tags won't allow them to change any of the settings on the unit. Now a word about price. So for the system that you see here, the Nest Secure, the pack, $399, that's the base unit. Two of these detect sensors and two of these tags. You can expand the system, of course. Additional tags are $25 each. Additional sensors are $49 each. That's a little bit on the expensive side when you look at these sensors that you can buy for some of the competing systems. But remember, these sensors are dual action. They're not just magnetic motion sensors for doors and windows, but they're also motion sensors for movement inside a room. So they do a little bit more than a regular sensor. If you're having trouble with connectivity for these, then you, for $69, you can buy a range extender. And Nest also offers professional monitoring. That is a little bit on the expensive side. Again, it's more like a traditional alarm system. It's $29 a month, but that comes with no commitments. If you sign up for a three-year contract, it goes down to $19 a month. But remember that signing up for a three-year contract essentially locks you into $684 of payments over 3 years. So combined with the base unit, that's over $1,000. That's one of the reasons why TechHive likes the competing Ring system so much, because its monthly monitoring is only $10. So that gives you an idea of the Nest Secure and how the app works and how you set it up. If you're looking into buying one, I hope that helps.